Okay, hi everyone!
Hi guys, how you doing?
Yep, how's everything going?
What's popping? What's happening? Welcome back to our channel.
Welcome back everyone.
Channel O and A.
I just got this thing thinking we've got a channel, channel O and A.
But it's a channel though.
Okay, just leave it as channel Ope and Ayo. That's it. Done.
Okay, welcome back guys. Hope you didn't miss us too much. We missed you. And we're here again.
Yep, live and direct.
Live and direct, we're back in the UK.
Yep.
You know, our home country. Mm-hmm. Actually, no, Nigeria is my home country. Nigeria is our home country.
Well, guys, you already know, I'm British fan.
So we're back in the UK. It was a lovely holiday.
It was.
Thank you for all your messages. And let's move on to what we want to do today.
Ooh, what we're talking about today. What we're talking about today. Spicy. What are we talking about?
Hot gist. So today we're going to talk about planning our wedding.
Yep.
Okay. We've had a few messages and a few DMs and a few comments telling us to talk about, you know, how we planned our wedding. So we're just going to tell you how we've done the planning. There was no magic involved. It was just two people putting their heads. You know what juju is?
Yes.
Black magic. If you knew what juju was.
Black magic. Voodoo. Wow.
You don't know what juju was.
What? Okay, what is juju?
Because I used juju to marry you.
That's not even funny. That's not funny. That's actually not funny. You need to repent.
Okay.
So I'm wondering. No, joking. Okay, it's real love, boys. Not black magic.
It's real love. Because have you seen that? Let's not digress.
Exactly.
You remember that whole
video?
No,
baby, let's not digress.
Oh, sorry. So we want to talk about the wedding. What did you say it was?
How we planned the wedding.
Planning the wedding. Mm-hmm. Planning our wedding. Ope and Ayo's wedding.
Davis 2013.
Yeah, best wedding in 2013. Best Nigerian wedding in 2013.
I like the way you brought it down. From best wedding to best Nigerian wedding. Best wedding in North London.
I was going to say best wedding in the UK. But yeah, best wedding in North London. In 2013, because there was other weddings.
On the 12th of October.
Or best wedding in October 2013. let's not
start trouble. Ah, okay. Nobody should come for us. So, anyway, yes. So let's get to the real deal.
Okay? Yeah. So planning the wedding. The first thing for me is get a book. Okay. So we got a note. You know, she had one of those big, you know, calendar, diary, things to do.
Maybe it was like a little small.
Yeah. Okay. Was it small? It was like medium size.
I'm going to go and look for it later.
Yeah, media. Yeah, you should actually, because then there's so many stupid things in there. So
my plan, stupid.
Not your plan, it was our plan. But then we had a lot in there, because basically it was everything we thought of, put it in there.
Basically.
Everything you researched, put it in there. Whatever you see online, put it in there. So it was like the book of, put everything in there, and then at the end of the day, look through to see what we want how we want to proceed.
Yeah.
So we had one of those, and go on.
So number one, get yourself a book so you can write down all the little bits and bobs.
Yeah.
Number two, get yourself a date.
Yeah.
You need a date. Obviously, you need the date that you're going to get married on.
So for us, if I can just bring something out, basically, I proposed to her, like I said, in January 2013, and we got married in October 2013. Now, the plan was not for us to get married in October 2013.
Yeah.
The plan was to get married in spring of 2014.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. However, for some spiritual...
Stop it. Now you're going to be thinking, they're going to be thinking elsewhere. First you said juju, now spiritual something.
No.
Anyway, seriously. Basically, because we were in the church, obviously we were in the church together, and the church were like that. They don't want us to, you know, be engaged for so long.
Yeah.
So we had to bring the wedding forward to October.
But I was looking forward to bringing the wedding forward, because I actually wanted to get married ASAP. If it was possible, after proposing in January, I wanted to get married in February. But obviously, Nigerian wedding, you want to plan. Because I remember her shouting, oh, you need 1 year to plan.
You need quite a while, but it's to each their own.
Yeah.
I mean, we managed to do it. Because we actually decided on a date in May, so that gave us about five months to plan. We were blessed because the date that we picked, or the date that picked us, was October. Was in October for various reasons. We actually wanted September.
Yeah,
initially,
we wanted September,
but it was booked up. You know, that's like the hot wedding period from about
May, June, from like May, June,
June to
from
September.
June to September. You know, especially the nice venues. So basically, we wanted September, but the nice venues that we wanted were not available in September. So we said, you know what, yeah, let's try our luck and go for
and
October.
And move it to October, yeah. Which we did.
Good.
So we've got the date out of the way. What next? What next? What next?
The next thing would be the guests.
Yeah.
So how many people do you want to be at your wedding? You need to agree that one right from the onset, okay? Mm-hmm. Agree how many people. Nigerian wedding, some people want 5,000 people there. Some people want 2,000. Some people want 1,000.
No,
okay?
No. Nigerian weddings, the couple usually only want about 100, 200
yeah,
people.
But the parents...
The parents want about 1,000, 2,000 people.
But that's where you as the children, because you're still children to your parents, even if you're 40 years old.
And this is their day of joy.
Exactly.
The day to show off to their friends.
So we made it clear to the parents, her parents and my parents, say, excuse ma, excuse sir.
Excuse. 1 minute. 1 second.
We are having only... Do you want to say how many guests we had? We wanted just 500, okay? Mm. They've seen our video.
No, we wanted 500 even max. We actually wanted, let's say...
No. Let's not even say we. So I wanted about 150 to 200.
Yeah, well, why? You've come back to that when you start telling stories again.
We're coming to that. Mm. I wanted 150 to 200, and she wanted more because, let people see my wedding. I want to... Not like let people see my wedding. She wanted a bigger wedding.
Let's get this record straight.
Wait, I wanted less.
Anyone who knows me know that I don't even know.
You were clamoring for more.
How was I?
Or maybe it was your parents. Because what I wanted was we just have a little me, your family,
in
my family
in the back garden. I know that's what you wanted.
Yeah, I wanted something classy. Your family, my family. I wanted like 150.
So my family's not classy.
No, I didn't.
I'm telling my mom. You see what I was saying? I'm telling. Alright then.
So I wanted something classy. 150 to 200 guests, you know, in a nice venue. Like, I had an idea of the wedding I wanted. However, you know, they wanted Boboero. Boboero means everybody comes, you know. Well, 500, I guess, was not so much of Boboero.
Anyway, the what we're focusing on is the number of guests. Yes. The point we're trying to reiterate is the fact that you guys decide the number of guests.
Yes.
At the end of the day, the more people you bring, the more mouths to feed.
Yes, and the more money you spend.
Exactly. Okay.
So if you're on a budget like us, it's not like we're on a budget like that, but, you know, there was a bit of a budget. Which brings us to the next thing, actually.
There was a bit of a budge. The jets could not reach.
You're so silly.
Okay.
So, you have made me forget. That takes us now to the next thing. After you know the number of guests you want, then...
It's the budget.
Okay.
Some people have a massive budget.
Yeah, for like 1 million. Some people spend
$1 million. Some people have a small budget, but you'll never know. Because the wedding is still cute. Still classy.
So that's where planning comes into play.
Exactly.
So, you know, it's not like we spend 1 million for our wedding. Do you understand? We're not telling you how much we spent.
Sure didn't.
But we didn't spend too much. We spent a lot though.
In what? Beans?
No. We actually spent a lot. Because now thinking about it, I'm even thinking, where did that money come from? However, Jehovah Jireh.
Ah. My Jehovah God, Jireh, that provides. Hey.
Jehovah Jireh provided. So, yeah. What did we say?
So, budget.
So, the budget. So, you need to agree on the budget. Let's try and be a bit serious now.
Yeah.
So, you actually need to sit down and agree on the budget. Right. She obviously was not thinking too much about budget. All she wanted was, I want this, I want that, I want this. It would be nice to have this, it would be good to have that. And me, obviously, always having my calculating brains there. I was always the one calling her. You want this one? This one alone is £10,000. Do you understand? Without looking at any other thing. So why not? Let's get this one so that we can meet. So get a budget for everything. So what we now did was like a rough estimate of how much we wanted to spend. Okay, in fact, let's go to the next thing, then we'll come back and bring it all together.
Wait, because we need to stress the importance of a budget and the unity on the budget. So that there's no fight and so nobody is unpaid on the wedding day.
It's true, because...
Don't go and...
Okay, let me not open any... Because I went for the wedding one time, because they've not finished paying the... Was it the makeup artist? See fight on the wedding. To me, that was just the end of the wedding. And in fact, I don't know why the makeup artist did that. That was bad. But she made it clear that you know who paid me. Normally, I think you pay balance on the wedding. So at this time, maybe they went to over budget. I don't know. Or they under budgeted for the wedding. But this makeup artist was not having it. She was like, you need to pay me before I do the makeup for the touch-up. Because obviously, they've done the wedding.
Yeah.
Because now the reception time. Mm-hmm. They wanted to do the touch-up or change actually the whole makeup.
Yeah.
And there was a big fight there. Mm-hmm. And people were begging. I think somebody now had to now pay the makeup artist. So you don't want that.
Yeah, that's true.
So plan and budget for your wedding.
Yeah.
Every penny. Trust me, every pound, every penny counts. Okay? Fire on.
Take it from there. Next, I think, is choosing your vendors.
Yes. Okay.
Now, I think in the day and age that we are in with Instagram, social media, I think it's so much easier.
Yes. Because in our time, when I say our time, you think we got married like 15 years ago. But our time, 3 years ago, we were not on Instagram. I don't even think I knew Instagram existed. Mm-hmm. Because I think I joined Instagram after my wedding. Or after our wedding. It's funny I said my wedding.
Yeah, because you married yourself.
No, it's funny I said my wedding because I remember during our wedding,
mm-hmm.
one of your friends was asking me, so when is Oppy getting married? And I said, it's not Oppy's wedding. It's me and Oppy. He was like, so when is Oppy's wedding? That's what she said. I'm not squaring with her, you know. In fact, I'll tell you who she is after. I don't want to mention it in camera. Oh, like, it's our wedding, you know, and that brings me to another point. It's your wedding, okay? It's two people. It's you, the man and the woman. You guys plan together. You need to agree together.
That's true.
Because most times, the guy just leaves the girl to do everything.
That's true.
Trust me, there's a lot of stress.
And make all the decisions. There's a lot of stress.
Which is why some people get a wedding planner to do the planning for them.
However, and I think that does work for some people.
It does
because
work.
It's like, you've taken... You're already stressed enough with the fact that you're getting married. It's a big thing. So if you feel like you can take the edge off that by having a wedding planner, and there are so many good wedding planners.
Very good. We know some.
Good. Yeah, some.
If you want,
ask us.
Not for free.
Yeah, not for free.
You have to pay us.
Definitely loads to recommend. Really good ones. But
so we were on a budget, so we didn't have a wedding planner. We thought, you know what,
But we did have a day organizer.
Yes.
I do feel like if you don't have a wedding planner, try and have a day organizer because As the bride, as the groom, your eyes cannot be everywhere.
Mm.
Your family members as well, them too, they'll be doing different things.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's good to have someone, a date planner that no one knows of, so that even if there's any disrespect, at the end of the day, I don't know you.
I don't know you, fam.
I don't know you.
So, wait. Actually, you know what, let's save some of the things that happened on the wedding. Because I'm going to do another video about the actual wedding day. Because now you guys have seen the video, a 20 or 30 minutes clip. Obviously, you can't really see everything that happened. So there are some things that happened behind the scenes.
Mm. I think we should go back one step. Just the importance of choosing your vendors.
Okay.
Do your research. Speak to people like me. God, you made me actually know.
No, I still think we'd touch on the important stuff.
Baby, you just cut me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry. Nothing. It's all yours.
Yeah, so choosing a vendor is very important. Shop around, look on Instagram and see what you like. Like I said, there's a lot of information on Instagram. Mm. You have a friend that's really good at makeup, tell her to refer you to someone. Tell her who she would use, you know. You have a friend who really likes photography, ask them who they would use.
Yeah,
like,
true.
And I think that's what we did because God knows I didn't know about makeup at all. God.
I didn't even know about anything.
I didn't know. Yeah.
And do you know what? Yeah.
We just wanted to dance.
No. True. Basically, we just baby, you're making us go around. Let's finish this one.
Okay.
This vendor's part. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, I didn't know that the wedding market was this big.
Mm.
The wedding market is really, really big. Mm. So until I was getting married, or until we were getting married, we didn't know, you know, how big the market was.
Yeah.
There's like 2 million makeup artists. Do you understand? There's like 8 million photographers. So, you know, and then, so we had to make that decision of who we want and why we wanted them. So we actually listed a few. Before we now chose, obviously, who we chose.
The chosen few.
The chosen few. And, you know, we're really happy with you guys. In case you guys are watching, all our vendors on our day, we love you guys. You gave us the wedding of our dream.
Yeah.
Our dream wedding, you know, and obviously you captured everything.
Yep. And some of them are still very good friends today.
Very good friends.
Y'all know yourselves.
You know. So, which is obviously part of who you choose or who
exactly.
As a vendor.
I feel like when you have a good vendor, you can actually be friends with them.
Funny enough, let's list some of these vendors. Okay.
Well, the ones that we
No, not we're not listing the vendors we had, but when we say vendors, here's what we're talking about. So we're looking at the photography. Do you understand? That was very important for us. Because you look back 20 years and say, these are my pictures. So we wanted one of the best photographers in our time. So photography, the video, the cinematography and the videography. You guys have seen our video. It was fantastic. You know, we went, we actually seen, you know, her work a few times. And she's, we're like, excellent. You know, let's get her.
Yeah.
Do you understand? And I remember when we met, let's not talk too much.
Yeah.
So the videography, the photography, what's next?
The makeup.
The makeup.
Yeah.
To me, the makeup was not so big, but you know, it's big for her.
Yeah. So you don't, you want to say you didn't wear makeup on that day?
Excuse me. I didn't wear makeup. Please. Before they think, what's that guy?
Stop. Don't let anybody come for us.
Okay, wait. But you know the guy.
You guys.
So, I did not wear makeup. Please check.
Mm-hmm.
Don't go and say anything. So,
okay, you did not wear makeup.
Makeup for me was not big. Okay? It was not,
yeah.
But what food was big for me? Thank you. Food.
You like
because food. You don't want to go to a wedding. I don't want to spoil anybody's name, so obviously we're not mentioning anybody's name. But we've gone for weddings where after you eat, you come back home and you're stewing for 1 week.
Listen. Some people might be eating their dinner.
Okay, sorry.
You just go and visit the toilet. Visit the ladies.
So it's, you know, we are very picky about who we want it. In terms of food, okay? Drinks, we've done our drinks by ourselves, so there was not like, we didn't get a vendor to do the drinks for
cake.
Us. Cake as well. Very important.
Yeah.
Not so important for me, but important for my wife.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she wanted a wedding cake and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
Then the things like the car that's taking you there, I couldn't be bothered. Basically, let me tell you what happened with the car. So basically, we wanted a, was it a Jaguar? Not a Jaguar, we wanted a, what's that? The Continental Bentley. We wanted one of those.
We wanted
a Rolls Royce.
Okay, yeah.
One of those Continental, you know, old school Rolls Royces. Rolls Royces, is that correct English?
Bagel.
Old school Rolls Royce or Rolls Royces, anyone, choose. English is not my first language.
Ah, we know.
So, we wanted one of those ones, and then after we looked at the budget, I was just like, man, forget this Continental.
Let's go in a Rolls Toyota. Royce that we want.
Not Toyota. So then we now saw one Jaguar like that. At the end of the day, we went for the Jaguar because it saved us like £500, okay? Mm-hmm. So, that's where budgeting and the choosing your vendor comes in as well. Because obviously, if you have a budget of £5,000, for example, for the photography, and you know the vendor you want wants to charge you £10,000, how do you reconcile the two?
Mm-hmm.
Is that you steal money, or you up your budget a bit?
Okay,
so let's go on. Okay.
Okay. So, what else did we have to think about? I know one. We had to make sure you engage your families. Let them know what's going on.
Yeah.
Even though it's for us, we made it very clear from the get-go that it is our wedding. Mama, you get back. Daddy, get back.
No, I remember your dad saying, the wedding is our own. So her dad wanted to be the one to dictate what we do on our wedding day.
So wait, dictate? Is my dad Hitler?
Okay, sorry. But that's what he wanted. He said, the wedding is our own. He said, anniversary and any other thing, you guys can do it. But the wedding is the parents.
He said, you can do your wedding again on your first anniversary.
Exactly. And we're like, Daddy, no, Daddy, we're not having that. So
no, you were like, okay, Daddy.
No. No, we're like, no. I remember this one. You almost cried every time.
Yeah.
He's like, no, you keep doing this. In fact, I think at some point they wanted like 800 guests. And we're like, no, we don't want more. They said, oh, they wanted this person. Anyway, they even wanted to choose vendors for us.
Mm.
We were like, no.
No.
And we actually, so I think one thing, let's pick up a lesson there. So you guys need to decide what you want, okay? And then tell your parents.
Yeah.
Okay? And then you need to stand your ground.
Mm.
So stand your ground and say, this is what I want. This is what we want. We planned this. Basically, we're just telling you to inform you, okay? We don't want any issues on the wedding day. Do you understand? We don't want any clashes.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so let's agree now. So we took everything, our plans to them, in terms of the budget as well. So in terms of the budget, I'm pleased to let you know that the parents obviously supported us. So it was not all our money, even though I was very rich at that time.
God bless you.
So it was not all our money. So we said, you know, Daddy, Mommy, where can you come in? You know, I took to my parents as well. where can you come in, what can you help us with, and obviously we handle the rest of the budget. Okay, so engaging your parents is very important.
Make them see reason, because at the end of the day, it is a joyous it is a joyous occasion for them, especially like me. Obviously, I don't know about Ayo, but I'm the favorite child. I am the golden child. So
you're not the favorite child.
Okay, all right. You wouldn't know what a favorite child is. So you
no, I mean, I know I'm not the favorite, because usually the first and the last borns are the favorite.
Yes.
So I'm not necessarily.
So
the favorite,
what am I?
But I'm loved.
You're the first. I'm the first, rather. So that means I'm.
I don't know why you're not the favorite, even though you're the first.
Anyway, so like I said, it's a day of joy for them as well. So you need to, you know, try and make them see reason, and I'm sure with prayer and fasting, they'll come around.
Yeah, yeah. There was a lot of.
There was a lot of tension.
A lot of tension and a few clashes, you know, with parents. In fact, I'm not coming. I think one time somebody said, in fact, do your wedding by yourself. I'm not coming. I'll watch the video. I'll video.
Yeah, so, but yeah, that's another important thing. And I think another important thing for us, because obviously we just love being the center of attention and, you know, our wedding had to be about us. Was definitely an activity for the wedding.
So basically, we wanted to do stuff. So basically, we wanted the wedding to be about us. What is that? Sorry, 1 second. We wanted to make the wedding about us. We made that clear from the onset.
We told that to our parents, that it's not even about you.
It's not about you. So, and that's where, in terms of planning the wedding, or the activities, because that's what we want to say now. The activities, we wanted to plan what we were going to do on our wedding, okay? So we wanted to be the center of attention.
Attraction, attention, everything.
Yeah. So, because you find that sometimes, I've gone for some weddings, okay? And then, the bride and the groom are just sitting there. Nobody's even sending.
They're just there.
Everybody is doing their own thing. Do you understand? Some people even sit down in circles and they're gisting. We didn't want that in our wedding. We wanted everyone to focus on us.
All eyes.
Okay? So that's when we now said
that we're gonna do a dance. Obviously, I taught Ayo all his dance moves.
Hey!
Anyone can testify.
Wait, okay.
Everyone knows me. That's just me. I just like to dance.
Me, I don't lie, okay? I'll tell you guys the truth. About dancing, in 2013, you know, Okoyemi Davis, she made me, you know, get more interested in dancing because she used to dance a lot. So I wouldn't lie. She didn't teach me how to dance. However, I took more to dancing because of her. And she did not teach me how to dance. Now, she was way, if you guys have seen it, she was a better dancer than me. You know, it's very sad. Because some people even made it very clear. They said, the winner is Ope and Ayo. Hey, Ope and Ayo. So for me, one thing I did was, I was like, I'm not going to carry last. I'm like, you know,
I'll do it.
I'm like, I must dance. I was dancing. Even when I was tired, I was like, I know I must dance. Because then, looking back at the video now, imagine if I was not dancing, to now just be hard dancing. Because I've gone to some weddings.
I've seen that before.
Yeah.
Definitely. One is putting it in, and the other person is just giving it a two step.
Yeah, so I was like, even though I could not meet her, or I could not beat her, at least let me just try
and get there. Oh baby, you did as well. You got there.
Well, try, you know.
Ah, give them.
So instead of talking, we said, okay, you know, we'll do the wedding dance. Okay, sorry, say the story.
We'll do the wedding dance, and that's where my brother and sister came in.
Yeah, my brother and sister helped.
They helped us with the dance moves. They made up the dance moves for us, and we like a little quarter of it, and then we just thought, oh, we'll just go with it.
Yeah.
We even got a mix. We got a mixtape or something, because we actually put the songs together.
Yeah, so we put the songs together. And this dancing thing, it was not like we were practicing for ages. It was a week before the wedding.
Yeah.
It was like a week before the wedding. We're just like, you know what, let's do something.
Yeah, exactly.
And then we done the dance. And then a day before the wedding, I lied. 2 days before the wedding, I said I wanted to do something special for her.
Oh,
and then I recorded that song, which was... number one on iTunes. So I sang a song for my lovely wife. Ah, that song.
Which I didn't know.
You know what? Yeah,
actually
I'm going to do the remix.
I'll do the remix.
It's my song.
Man. No, but I want to remix it for you.
You cannot remix it for me. It's my song and it's your name. So I said, you know, I'll sing for
just
my wife.
Just one song and it's already Bugang.
So I think we've run through everything. The dates, the budget, choosing your vendors, engaging your parents, choosing your guests. In fact, we didn't even say that. That's very important.
What, choosing your guests?
Yeah, the guest list.
There's a little thing that I've seen on like a little memes thing, basically choosing your guest. Have you spoken to the person in the last 1 year? Are the person like a relative of your family? There's ways of choosing it, because trust me, people want to be your friend. Once you get that ring, people want to be your friend.
I know.
Because everybody wants to attend. Even we're looking for a wedding to attend. Please, invite us to your No, seriously.
Usually there's not many weddings around this time, but yeah.
No, but we haven't got that many weddings for next year. Invite
please
us.
Please invite us. We're free.
Please. Three people, please. Me, Ayo, and Mickey.
And we don't eat much.
We don't eat much.
Because I have some nice new stuff, you know, in my wardrobe, and I'm looking for where to wear them to.
Are you the groom? Please don't mind him.
Okay, you guys. I think you guys have heard it. We're going to round up now.
Yeah.
We've already gave you the lessons. Thank you so much for your support.
Thank you very much. We
actually
much,
really
guys.
Enjoyed this experience.
Yeah.
I love it. And you guys are making us enjoy it more.
Definitely.
Keep telling us what you want to hear. Keep giving us the feedback.
Yep.
We love the feedback that you give. And that's what inspires us to actually do what we do. So we're going to let you go now. And this is us.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Hello.
No. This is us saying bye. So say bye.
Bye.
Bye. See you guys in a bit. Hopefully it won't be too long. Bye.